Hi, I'm Dominic Pizzullo, and this is how my global journey started. Growing up in New York City, I felt like I always had an upper hand. No matter where I went in the world, I'd be prepared. But nothing could have prepared me for the journey I was about to take. 3 months after getting my high school diploma, I found myself on a plane to the UK. No more living in the Bronx with my family and friends. No more all-boys private school with 107 kids. Just 75 strangers and I up for the amazing opportunity to break out of the ordinary and spend our first ever college semester in London. It'd be an understatement to say this wasn't the way I planned on starting my college career, but chances like these don't come around often. Besides, who am I to complain about being sent to London for 4 months? I still remember when I first arrived here. It almost didn't feel real to me. I couldn't believe that I'd actually be living here for an entire semester. I was in the New York City of Europe. I was prepared, or at least that's what I thought. Everything here was so much different than I expected, and in the best way possible. I was so eager to explore the city, start my classes, and get to know all the other students. I was finally in college, and I promised myself that I would make the absolute most out of the situation. The first day here, I decided to start exploring South Kensington. It felt similar to uptown Manhattan, but it still felt so far from home. I visited local shops, I got to meet some local people, but it all only made me want to see more. I wanted to see just how much London had to offer me. I got to see Big Ben, the Parliament Building, the Tower of London, and even the White Cliffs of Dover. I've never seen anything like it back in New York. London had such a unique combination of history and modern technology, and both somehow seamlessly fit together. One of the best parts about London was how easy it was to travel. I spent a week in Edinburgh, and that allowed me to see a whole new atmosphere without even leaving the UK. I also spent the night in a small suburb outside of London, and even that felt like hundreds of miles away from South Kensington. But somehow, the feeling of being so far from New York never bothered me. England had become my second home, and I couldn't be happier. I really enjoyed my classes too. London had tons of opportunities to experience its history firsthand, and all the field trips my teacher sent me on let me do just that. But even more helpful than any of my classes was my service learning project. I spent every Tuesday morning at the YMCA boutique, a thrift store to help the less fortunate. Working the till always gave me the chance to get to know people from the neighborhood, and even working in the stockroom let me get to know the other workers better. At first, I didn't see how working at the YMCA was helping anyone, but it taught me to look at a bigger picture. The YMCA helps thousands of people every day who can't help themselves. Even as a volunteer, I feel like I benefited from the YMCA in more ways than one. As cliche as it may sound, my time in London has been life-changing. One semester in college, and I can already say I've begun my journey toward becoming a citizen of the world. Anyone took me completely by surprise, and looking back, I'm genuinely thankful for that. But none of the sights I've seen, locals I've met, or knowledge I've gained would have been the same without the friends I've made through NUM. I came here, just 75 strangers in it. Now, I'm leaving with 75 friends. 75 people that no matter what, I'll always be able to say started my global journey with me. From weekends exploring London nightlife to all-nighters in the PC lab, and none of it ever got old. Of course, everyone makes new friends when starting college, but not many can say they've had an experience quite like ours. Now, you're all probably thinking the same thing I am. What next? And the truth is, I have no idea. But what I do know is that no matter whatever or wherever next is, I'll always look back on NUN as one of the greatest experiences of my life. As for London, it hasn't seemed the last of me yet. Like I said, who knows what's gonna happen next. Thanks for watching.